students, welcome to the FTR series of competition community. And with the subject of Indian geography, I am with you, Aga Singh. This is the fourth video based on Indian geography in which we are going to cover climate, vegetation, soil and rock system topic based on MCQ explanation. Clear? So let's begin with the first question. And first question is based upon climate. Question says here, question is based upon assertion, recent type of question. Assertion says India has a tropical monsoon type climate, and reason for this assertion is India is located exactly between tropical latitude. Clear? In first statement, you have seen what type of climate India experience, that is tropical monsoon type of climate. This statement is correct. Why? Look, monsoon. Clear? What do you mean by monsoon? Monsoon means a seasonal reversal of wind. Seasonal reversal of wind. Clear? And in respect of India, you can see this seasonal reversal of wind in clear manner. In June, during June, or you can say during summer season. ITCZ comes to near ITC topic of Cancer. This is ITCZ, or you can say a low pressure belt. Clear? A low pressure develop over another part of India, or you can say near topic of Cancer. Clear? And high pressure gets developed over Indian Ocean. And you know, wind moves from high pressure to low pressure. So during summer season, you can observe wind moving towards India. But during August and December, or you can say during winter season, this condition gets reversed. How? High pressure gets developed over India and low pressure gets developed over southern ocean, southern hemisphere. Why? Because ITCZ get placed here due to southward movement of sun. Clear? And in this case, you can see wind moving away from India. So yes, India experiences seasonal reversal of wind during June, during summer season. You can see winds coming to India, and during winter season, you can see, you can observe wind moving away from India. So yes, India experiences a monsoon type of climate. And this type of climate gets very well developed over tropical region. But India is not exactly located between tropical latitude. Then why India experiences this tropical monsoon type of climate? It's because of Himalaya. Clear? Yes? When you see latitudinal extension of India, you can clearly see that Tropic of Cancer separates India into two equally parts. Southern part of India located in tropical region, but northern part of India is located in subtropical region. But India does not experience subtropical type of climate because Himalaya is situated north part of India and it obstructs cold Siberian winds which comes from subtropical area also. That's why India experiences tropical type of monsoon climate. So reason is incorrect, or reason is false, but assertion is correct, and hence option B is the right answer of this question. Here, let's move to the next question. And next question is based upon in which of the following states does the monsoon arrive first. Here, look, during summer season, when we observe onset of monsoon, monsoon gets bifurcated into two branches. Branch which comes from Arabian Sea is called Arabian Sea branch, and branch of monsoon which comes from Bay of Bengal is called Bay of Bengal branch. Yeah, and this monsoon branch of Arabian Sea gets first collide with this southern part of India, and hence you can see Kerala is situated here. Here,
it means that
Kerala receives monsoon first. Here,
next question is,
which are the months for monsoon normally in Tamil Nadu? Tamil Nadu receives rainfall not in summer season but in winter season. Clear? So you can easily eliminate these two options, March, April and June, July. During November and December, high pressure gets developed over India. Clear? Why? Because position of ITCZ is near to Tropic of Capricorn due to southward movement of sun. Clear? And winds, as you know, move from high pressure to low pressure. During this journey, some of the wind gets moisture from Bay of Bengal and causes rainfall in Tamil Nadu. Clear? So Tamil Nadu receives winter rainfall due to retreating monsoon. This is also known as retreating monsoon. Hence, the right answer of this question is November and December. Clear? Let's move to the next question.
And next question is,
based upon soil, which of the following soils of India has been formed due to weathering of basaltic lava? And right answer of this question is regolith soil. Look, due to erosion of basaltic lava, we can see development of black soil, which is also known as regolith soil. This basaltic lava is been distributed over the Deccan Plateau. In terms of states, you can say Maharashtra, Karnataka, and other such states. Clear? So, right answer of this question is regolith soil or black soil.
Let's move to the next question.
And next question is based upon lateroid soil. Which one of the following statement is not true for lateroid soil? Clear? Lateroid soil formed due to process of leaching. And this leaching process clearly visible in moist climatic region, or you can say where rainfall is greater than evaporation. Clear? And due to this, waters get accumulated at surface. This is surface of soil. Water gets accumulated at surface of soil because this surface receives more rainfall than evaporation. Clear? And after this accumulation, this water carries micronutrient which were present at surface with it, and it gets percolated below the surface. Clear? Let's have a look in the given options. Option A, they are the soils of the humid tropical region. Yes, humid, because which place receives more rainfall is considered normally in terms of humidity. They are highly leached soil. Yes, due to the process of leaching. Their fertility is low. Yes, because micronutrients get percolated below the surface, which is very necessary and essential for the fertility of soil. And option D, so this option is wrong. And right answer of this question is option D, because question has been asked upon not true for lateroid soil. So option D, or they are rich in lime, is not true regarding lateroid soil. So right answer of this question is option D. Let's move to the next question. Which of the following soil range is spread over most of the area of India? Alluvial soil, or black soil, or red soil, or white soil, or forest soil. So this is the distribution of different types of soil. You can see this light green color part. This denotes distribution of alluvial soil. You can say alluvial soil spreads most part of the India and it accounts around 40% part. Yeah, this question is also asked in CGPSC exam, and right answer of this question is option A, that is alluvial soil. Yeah, let's move to the next question. Next question is based upon natural vegetation. In India, which type of forest among the following occupies the largest area? And answer is tropical moist deciduous forest. Yeah, what do you mean by deciduous forest? Those forests which shed their leaves are called deciduous forest. So India, you can see a widespread covering of deciduous forest, and deciduous forest is classified in two parts, that is in moist classification or as dry deciduous forest. So moist deciduous part covers most of the part of Indian vegetation system. Now let's move to the next question, and next question is based upon the alpine vegetation in western Himalayas is found only up to height of 3000 meters, while in the eastern Himalayas it is found up to a height of 4000 meters. The reason for this variation in the same mountain range is what? Here, look. Western part of Himalaya is extended up to 37 degree north latitude, and eastern part of Himalaya is extended up to 27 degree north latitude. In this scenario, western part receives less insulation, which results in less temperature comparatively to eastern part of Himalaya, and this less temperature led to lack of rainfall in western part. And due to combination of these two factors, you can see development of vegetation in western part is less than eastern part. Clear? So what is the reason for this variation? Is reason is latitudinal extension. So right answer is option B, because you can see description of latitudinal extension in this option. Eastern Himalayas are nearer to equator and sea coast than western Himalayas. Clear? So here are the questions based upon climate, vegetation, rock system and soils of India. Questions regarding different topics will be covered in different videos which you will get according to the schedule.
CGPSC की संपूर्ण तैयारी के लिए कॉम्पिटिशन कम्युनिटी के YouTube चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कीजिए और डेली अपडेट्स के लिए बेल आइकन को प्रेस करना ना भूलें।